This is not sin.
No, it's not.
You're who? Elena.
The Squalid Queen. So she's another one of the sisters.
Oh, yeah, okay, that's...
Whereas they all have elements. What was the queen's name? Nashandra.
Nashandra,
is just the dark and weakness. She is... And Nadalia was like ash and soot. She is squalor and filth.
And she's talking to me? She's actually like...
Yeah.
Wow. What did she say? She said, you're not the...
Deserving of the mire.
That is...
Like, you are not deserving of this... So, she got here... So, like, Nashandra tried to fuck up Drang Lake, didn't do a really great job, right? Nadalia really got to the Old Iron King hundreds of years too late,
uh-huh.
And then had Rame fuck up that area for her, right?
Yeah.
She is the goddamn maiden of the dragon of poison, and became the high priestess of this culture, and now it is just this horrible, ruined mess.
So, is this the fight you were saying is like the Nash fight, like, but better?
It's like Nashandra, but it's like an actual fight instead of not a fight. So yeah, be very wary of your stamina here. And just take a minute and learn her attack. She has a ground explosion.
Yeah, okay.
It's pretty obvious to see that coming. Her left hand gets all dark and shit. She teleports a lot.
Okay.
She does that. So that homes in. So there's the one where there's one, and then there's the one that there's two. And the one that there's two, you're not supposed to move. And the one that there's one, you are supposed to move.
Oh my god. Okay, so she doesn't have a lot of life, but...
She's fucking tough.
You gotta be careful of that.
She doesn't have a lot of life, but her attacks are, like, now you, that's all of it.
Okay.
You've seen all of her attacks. They're actually pretty easy to avoid. The only one you didn't see is, like, a swipe with her attack. But they all have relatively long lead-ups. Like, you can see them, right? They're not, it's not fucking, Veldstat. It's not Smelter,
mm-hmm.
right? It's like, they have long wind-ups, a lot of them are spells, and you just have to dodge and hit.
You're saying about the explosive one.
Right. So that's a player spell as well. And what it does is it creates an explosion that triggers 3 seconds after it shows up. There's one where she'll put one, and it'll appear in your view. You'll be able to see it, and it'll appear relatively close to you. Move out of its way, right? Move away from it because it'll kill you.
Correct.
But there's one where she'll put two to either side of you, and if you try and get away, you will move into them.
I see. Okay.
And you can get, like, you can get a couple hits on her here, but gain your stamina. So, her original one is different from her subsequent attacks. She will never say you are not deserving of the mire again.
Right.
Instead, she'll be like, whatever. Time for you to rot like shit, you shit rotter.
Shit.
Yeah, you... Like, this is a fight where I would actually consider, if you die a couple more times... Take some of your armor off. Take the crossbow off at least next time, right? You need distance on that
one. Yeah.
And like, whoa, she was right in front of you.
I didn't see where she reappeared. Okay.
Okay, so here's the other part of her boss fight that's rough. So she's not that tough.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Veldstat?
Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh my god.
He's not as tough as regular Veldstat. Not nearly. But you will have to fight both simultaneously.
Oh my god. Alright.
So her summoning of Veldstat, completely random.
Okay.
There are times where she will never summon Veldstat. There are times in which you will kill Veldstat and she will summon him again.
Holy shit. Alright, so I tried a few attempts here at her.
Yeah, Veldstat coming in.
What the fuck? Wow, what a surprise at that, man.
It's like, holy fight shit. Veldstat, and he has all of his pre-power-up movesets.
But he's just weaker.
He's just weaker, but he does. He still hits just as hard.
Yeah. I noticed that he doesn't do the three swing as often.
No, and you may also, when you look at him, he seems to be slightly smaller,
mm-hmm.
and he doesn't have a lot of the effects that were on Veldstedt that made him look like a human.
So the key when he comes in is, like, keep both of them in view.
In view.
At the same time, yeah. Because fuck that
and
fire.
And always, spell. Always, always, like, Veldstedt is secondary. You're looking and listening for her spellcasting attempt, and the only time you can ever attack him is right after you have dodged one of her spells, regardless of whatever he's doing.
Going on.
And so you have to time it so that they're both open, and that sucks.
You treat them like normal enemies.
But the trick that I learned and told you, which can't, like, you coasted to victory, is that if you kill two or three skeletons, you start the summoning trap over. But if you kill one skeleton, they'll stay out forever.
She thinks that's just enough to still get you.
And two skeletons, as long as you, like, go all the way back and forth and train them to one side and then go to her, they're not going to catch up, and you actually have breathing room.
So you just kite them around while you fight her.
Yeah.
And that's fine.
And that's how I beat it, and you totally, like, that's one of those pieces of advice. I'm like, is that going to work for you?
Yeah.
How you're going to do it?
Yeah.
It totally works!
Especially since I'm naked.
Yeah, you're naked.
I fought her all stripped up, and she was all like, oh, get that horrible body away from
me. She's the queen of filth.
Yeah, and I was like, no, I'm going to rub it up on you, girl. Come on, you know you love it. But yeah, that worked out.
You got her. Just one.
Yeah!
Ooh. Wasn't that good advice?
That was great advice.
Leave two skeletons. Oh, let's look at her soul. Let's look at that.
All right.
The squalid. Wait! Look at that shit.
Oh, hold on a minute.
So I don't know if you remember, but this what remember
that
when
was
you got the dragon egg.
I remember exactly. Yes, this is it.
It's the same mural.
Yeah.
But blown way the fuck out.
Everyone worshiping the dragon.
Yeah, and now it makes more sense.
These
like,
were the-
what's that douchebag's name? The king's brother. Aldia. He must have known about this shit.
Yes.
Maybe he, like, it's possible that he sent the Drake Blood.
Because this is recreated way the fuck far away from where that original
was. So the Child of Dark accompanies the dragon, slowly amassing souls in anticipation of the coming day of vengeance.
The wondrous soul of this Augur of Wrath can
so she's wrath.
Acquire numerous souls or create something of great.
Put your shit back on, Wooly.
I will do.
And let's take a baby trip back out to Majula. So that we... Oh, the Drake Blood armor?
I like the cape.
Everyone likes capes.
I like the cape.
Because 72,000 is totally enough souls to get some stuff.
All right.
Do you have your gloves on? You do not.
I kept them off last time, remember? For...
That. Oh, I didn't remember
I kept the gloves off because I wanted to be able to carry my bow and arrow.
Right.
All right.
Well, put the gloves on. Because you're not going to need the bow and arrow. The crossbow.
We're done with that for now.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's make sure you can still roll properly. Yep. And let's take a quick trip to Majula.
Not a great roll, but it is a roll nonetheless.
Two over, dude. One down.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Because 72 grand, you can cash that in.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's do it.
Put it into health.
Yeah, you think so at this point?
Why not?
All right. Sure.
Like, you're at a place where it's like, you're just dumping shit anywhere anyway. Alright.
Yep.
Clean down.
We cashed in those souls. I dropped them all into vigor. I want to get that giant life bar like I see on those guys.
And those PvP videos.
Those fucking cool guys with the
life
bars.
Hey, Wooly, you know where you'll get your giant life bar?
Where?
At the end of that corridor.
Oh, shit.
That's where you will get... That is so beautiful.
God damn.
That is like a week of artist work. Right? Modeling that fucking thing?
Perhaps more than that.
Like, that is some effort. And, like, the little one that you see earlier in the game, there's no way you could just blow that up
to
that.
See what it is to be exactly. Alright, here's another bonfire.
I forgot that was there.
Don't mind if I do. And a lot of people are talking.
Try beanpole butthole. Try guts. I love that. That's not
thing.
The guts. That's literally
try guts.
Being guts.
All right.
I gotta go look. This is your arena. It is awesome. Isn't it?
Okay.
And notice how far the camera just pulled back?
Yeah. This looks like an arena for killing fucking dragons. What up, Sin?
Yeah!
What up, Sin? All right.
So now you get a good look at the spear straight through his chest. So here's the deal. This is a spoiler for his soul and for the ring you get in this area. Sin was asleep until the Drakeblood Knights and Sir Yorg showed up and pierced him through the chest with Yorg's spear.
Holy shit.
And the poison that was in his breast spewed out and destroyed the civilization.
Oh, you running? This motherfucker's running.
Sin is so cool. He is also insanely tough.
All right, let me get in.
He is also the dragon that you see in the original Dark Souls 2 CG trailer. Like with the weird eyes and all that shit.
Yeah.
So yeah, you're doing pretty good, but yeah, basically this is the core of his thing. Big wide sweeps that do shit tons of damage. That's the worst one. That thing. Cause it fucking hurts. And with the poison, so that causes poison to linger on the ground.
Wow. Okay.
Now, to those of you... Oh, you're dead. Oh, wow, you're not! to those of you who are familiar with Monster Hunter, this looks like a goddamn Monster Hunter boss fight.
Uh-huh.
This shit. It plays like one. So look at that. So those fireballs cause poison... cause toxin to stay, because fire is poison!
Holy shit. Oh man, he caught me
there. That's tough to avoid.
Yeah, he caught me there.
Basically, you find out that you need to be strafing as close to him as possible to the right or left the whole time. Because it's the only way.
Don't take more than two swings.
No, be very cautious. Be very cautious. Very cautious.
Ooh.
See, if he touches you with his feet, you just die.
That's manageable, but that's some shit.
Look at that!
Yeah, he's got a blade on his neck!
Like, it's this thing where, like, Yorg hit him with, like, a fucking super move, like, spear attack. And, like, it's this thing, it's like, it's in history. But it's like, what did that look like? He hits him with the spear, and the city just explodes! And, after you see that item over there?
Yeah.
That's Yorg.
Jeez.
Like, he died immediately. Of course, right?
Of course.
Like, he was point blank on the poison. Yeah, so the closer you are, the easier it is to avoid his flying attacks with strafing.
To avoid.
Avoid. You can avoid it, Willy. See, because from here, like, if he does the fire thing, it goes way past you. If he does the breath, it goes way... Like, you gotta be careful with your stamina, bro. You gotta be real, real careful. Yeah, and in this fight, you do run. No!
He was winding up by now.
No!
Oh! Interesting.
Yeah, so for all the dragon bosses, the 90 degrees in front of their head is
a fucking death ward, yeah.
Like, the fireball, you will always be safe if you run straight forward. Because, like, think about the angles.
Right.
Right? But it's just like, yeah, there are a lot of very technical aspects to this boss fight, and you have to have them all on lock. And that move is why I think this fight is, like, designed after Monster Hunter. See how easy that is? Like, you're... Because that is so similar to a move that almost every single enemy in Monster Hunter has. Jeez, that does lots of damage. So you're like totally safe. And yeah, if he lands on you, you die.
Understandable.
Back off. Ballsy.
Never enough to fucking get away from that one.
You do, but you have to start swinging the instant you're safe. Like, you move towards him, and, like, no, you have to roll, like, into him to dodge that thing, and then, like, start swinging before his neck has started to come down. You know?
Yeah.
So that you're safe at the same time he goes back to neutral. Hit him! Hit him! That fire breath animation is 3 damage.
Does the wings take damage too?
Yeah!
Okay.
Okay, now don't fucking chill out. Nice. But yeah, fire breath is your friend, dude, because it takes forever! What a fucking amazing boss fight.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Stop running. Run. See, like, fucking free, man. Careful. Hit him.
He moved.
Oh, you're good. So with those, it's like you reorient to look at him. Like, no, drink the instant you get up. Because you have the time. Wait. Now. See? It takes him that long to... I love that. They didn't just make the columns destructible. They made the stalactites destructible from the ceiling that only he can fly into. Just heal. See, you have the time. Yeah. Hit him. Now get it back. You're safe. Just get it back. You are so close to having this. Way to watch the talons. You are doing it, man. You are doing it! Check out his death animation. It's so awesome.
Fuck yeah. That felt
Let's
good.
Let's look at this dude's soul. But first, pick up your...
Oh, oof. Hell yeah.
Let's read about Yorg's ring and Sin's soul, shall we?
Oh, that lit up.
Of course it did. So, Sin's soul, it's a normal soul, it's not dark.
Yeah.
The king erected a magnificent city and the dragon slept soundly, till Sir Yorg disturbed it with a single great strike, and the dragon could bear its store of poison no longer. The rain of death toppled the city, but restored the dragon's purity.
Oh, man, talk about not what you wanted. Talk about a backwards plan.
Yeah, and that's Yorg right there at your fucking feet.
Holy shit.
Let's look at his ring, because it's actually a really cool ring.
Yes, in here.
I'm not sure where it is or what it looks like. There it is.
Ring of Sir Yorg, who sought the blood of an old dragon and invaded Shova, can deflect spells?
It will randomly deflect spells entirely.
Randomly?
Yes, so that's why he thought he could take the dragon.
Oh. When Sir Yorg faced Sin, the slumbering dragon, he drew blood with a flash of his steel. But Sin responded by spewing forth the poison that had long brewed within him, blanketing the city in a miasmic cloud. Holy shit.
And Yorg and his ring did not protect him, and he just burst dead immediately.
God, so there's people worshipping this thing and he fucking fights.
Dude, this dragon never wakes up and it lives underground and it's this magnificent god.
Oh,
and it will never wake up, right? So you just... And, like, you die if you get too close to it.
Yeah.
So it's clearly divine, right? So then you build this wonderful temple and then invaders wake the slumbering god and destroy... It's such a perfect myth.
Fuck, man. And there's, like, artwork and murals dedicated to showing you. Yeah, I guess I should.
Yes, you should.
Bam.
There it is. Let's take a look at the crown. Faint heat lingers in the ancient crown. Same thing that the other one said. There it is. King
erected the eternal sanctum below the earth to worship the great dragon, but the towering bulwark crumbled. Da, 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 da.
But these were events of long ago, and today no one even remembers the king's name. All right. That's two down!
Yeah!